Hey smokers, welcome to the trailer channel. In the last episode on the Colorado T3000, which I'm literally uploading the first episode right now, although this has been a few months apart between the filming of last episode and the filming of this one now. So, the goal in today's episode is to install MS-DOS, then Windows 3.1, and then Windows 2000. And we'll play around with the OSs at the end of the video a little bit more. So, someone thought it was interesting that I still used CDs. You know, stuff like this. Well, all I have to say to that is, I'm about to blow your fucking minds. Because I have floppy disks, MS-DOS 5.0 on a floppy disk, and apps. Now, these are only bootable into the actual OS. These are not installers. We're going to have to make those. But I do want to see if it will boot from the floppy drive, because if it can boot from this, then the floppy drive works. If it doesn't, then I'm going to have to put another floppy drive in there. And I might actually have one that I can use for that. So, let's go ahead and stick this in the drive. I don't have any zip disks. I don't have any tape drives. Not that that would matter. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and start it up. See if it starts up straight to what we want it to do, which is straight off the A drive. I like the sound these old computers make. Memory test takes a long time. We might upgrade the memory as well. Huh. That one's new. There we go. Now it's booting from the floppy drive. I thought about uploading this floppy, so you people can download it, put it on a floppy drive, and use it as is. But it should boot an MS-DOS shell. And the mouse even works! Oh, that is so cool. Okay. Can we play Snake? There we go. I even have Space Invaders on here. Isn't this cool? We're running MS-DOS and Shell on a floppy, but I was able to put games on it. Isn't this incredible? We're playing games on a floppy disk. But not just the floppy disk, the whole entire OS. I think this is the best I've ever done in this game. Of course, it would be leaning over a freaking camera. Missed it. Okay, you've seen enough of this. That's not what you're here for. You're not here for me playing Snake off of a floppy disk. Running MS-DOS. No, we are here to install MS-DOS and Windows 3.1 and then Windows 2000. Now, some of you might be wondering, why not Windows 2000 first? Well, the simple answer to that is, if I install Windows 2000 and then Windows 3.1, I won't be able to go back to Windows 2000 because Windows 3.1 doesn't have a boot manager. In fact, I don't even know if Windows 2000 would support being able to boot back to Windows 3.1. I'm hoping it does have a boot manager. Like, for those of you that have dual booted Linux before, like Ubuntu and Windows together, you will know it gives you a little menu. Exactly like this. Okay. So this right here is exactly what I'm looking for on that machine over there. Is I want to have the option to boot to Windows 3.1 or boot to Windows 2000. But if I went with 2000 first and then 3.1, it wouldn't have this boot menu. At least that's my theory. I may end up having to install two completely separate hard drives in this machine if I want that. But that's just a waste of good hard drives. So, I need Windows 7 on this machine because we are going to need to make our own floppies. Of course, I'll let you watch the start screen. Beautiful. Now, those of you with a keen eye will know, hey, the Scrapmaster doesn't have a floppy drive. And you'd be right. However, this is a floppy drive with USB. So that's what we're going to use to burn all of our disks. This is a known good floppy drive, or at least it used to be. Just like that. So now, all we need to do is grab a floppy disk. Luckily, I have a whole case of them right here. Oh, crap! Conveniently, three disks came out, which is all I'm going to use. Now, since I had a whole case of them, some of you might be asking, well, why not, put all of your installation disks on all one row? And the simple answer to that is, while that computer is using one of these disks, I can be going back over on this machine making the second or third disk for installation. Simply because I know these three disks will be good. Whereas if you're using like 20 disks, you might encounter one that's not good. And then at that point, you have to go back over here and reburn it anyway on another. Really, laziness is why, but also because I'm kind of stingy with my floppies. So, there is our first one. I have no idea what's on that disk. Not that it matters. So here we are. We have our stuff here. First thing I want to do, so we are going to install MS-DOS 5.0. But before we do that, we are going to use a special program called RotWrite. We are going to 5.0, give me, thank you, and we are going to burn the first image. And we make sure our floppy drive is selected if A or B does not come up here. I don't know how to help you. And number of copies, which is cool because you can make copies of this disk. I even see a read function. That, and it also tells you the percentage. This is a really, really good program if you're working on old computers like this and you're going to need floppy disks for installation. It's just better this way. Image successfully written, but I see a read. Huh, I can save an image. I have never tried that before. Should we try it now? So this is our number one installation disk, so I'm going to go ahead and throw that over there. But before we get too carried away, I want to see if I can't create an image. It's DOS, so what I want to save it as is DOS 5 TTC. I had never done that before. This isn't part of the video, but, well, it is now, but I just want to see if it will give me an image. I've never used this side of the program before. Is it there? Wow, it's just a file. Are you going to finish? Maybe that'll work. I'm not going to try it out right now. But that's cool. I think you can do that. So, of course, we're going to then select a second image and put the second disk in the drive. And this is what I'm going to be doing. For every single disk, we need to put in that other machine to make it boot and install. So this time we select image 2 and write. So here we go. Let's go ahead and enter setup, because what I want to do saying in 2018. Okay. So that wasn't helpful. BIOS feature setup. Boot sequence. Here we go. Okay. So CD-ROM, CA. CD-ROM, CA. That's a problem. So I can't set it to boot off the floppy drive first without going to the CD-ROM and then that. I don't think that's going to be an issue, though. Yes. So now it should boot off of the floppy drive. And I already have disk 2 done. So, we've encountered our first issue. It's not going to be as simple as it seems. Maybe I need DOS 6.62.2 for this to work. I don't know. So, I guess that's what I'm going to try to download, and then we'll try it. Stupid thing, shut off! It does not want to hard shut down. Thing I love about floppy disks is you don't have to have the computer on to take them out. Okay, so here we have installation one of the three disks for MS-DOS 6.22. Let's see if it will boot from it. If it doesn't, I'm going to have to use the floppy disk that did boot and then install escape memory test. Computers love cold weather, especially the fan bearings. So frustrating. Well, this is difficult. Okay, I have an idea. So here we are. Take 3000. I grabbed a disc I know is good. So it should work. This is one I used in a virtual machine. No memory test. Just get straight to work. Okay. Floppy drive is seeking. There we go. Yes! Beautiful. So, let me get started on burning these other discs. Okay, to continue setup, press enter. Configure hard disk first. Press Y. So I have two partitions on this drive. I forget the size, but one of them was about a gig or so, and the other one was... who knows? Okay, there's our second disc right here. And third one, drive and have it ready. Something tells me I may run into problems. Okay, you have configured some or all of your disk space for use with MS-DOS. The space is being formatted now. I'm hoping it's doing that little 2GB section. It was either 1.5 or 1.7. I don't remember. But I'm assuming since it's moving so quickly, it's just doing that section. We can take Windows 2000... and check behind it, make sure it didn't format the section for Windows 2000. It says you have configured some or all of your disk space, so, and I have configured it for some. While formatting your primary hard disk partition. Thanks! This computer's so old, I can't really use Linux for that. Let's try this. This is DOS 5.0. So, fdisk. Save me. Maybe it wants the old disk. Hey, hey, okay. So we want to, for display partition information. Yeah, so there's our 2 gig space. So I want to delete. Create a primary DOS partition. Can't fix this one. Is the maximum available size for a yes. Because I formatted that other partition with NTFS, so it shouldn't see it. This is a 8 gigabyte drive or 10 gig? I forget. Insert DOS system diskette and drive A. Press any key when ready. Oh man. This is scary working with this old stuff. Because if I encounter an issue like this and I can't find a way around it, that's it. I'm dead in the water. You just gotta try stuff and hope it works. Missing operating system? Really? Really? So, I may have to install DOS 5, and I have a plan for that. Reset button. I said reset button. Thank you. So what I might can do, boot off of this floppy, my trailer channel DOS 5 floppy, and then take one of these disks and put MS-DOS 5 on it, which I think is what I am going to do. Missing operating system? Did this just go out? This floppy drive? Oh, joy. Oh, joy, oh, joy, oh, joy. Okay. Now, work. So we're going to try DOS 5.0. Something that I know works with everything. Okay, so let's configure the BIOS to boot straight from the floppy drive. No CD-ROM, no hard drive. Straight from the floppy. Okay. This doesn't work, I'm out of ideas. But I do have a plan. Maybe. Better boot from the flop first. Hey. It's working. Okay. So now we can try this one. Go to DOS 5.0. Okay. Hey, look, it even... I've never seen this before. Oh, joy. Can I... Okay, so as cool as that is, it's not very useful. So let's go to DOS 5.0 install disk, press the reset button, and see what we get. I am out of ideas at this point. We may have to try DOS 7.0, 7.1 or something, the China DOS. Might change that zip drive out for another floppy drive, I'm not sure. Missing operating system, okay. So let's boot off of this drive. Stick this drive in there, DIR, and then boot the setup. Okay, now we're going to take this out, stick this one in, and then we are going to refresh, which is F5. Haha. Okay. So I'm using this as a boot floppy for my setup disks. And look at that! Settings are correct. A shell? Okay. It's that easy? I like DOS 5.0. It's a shame you have to use a boot floppy. So technically there's 4 disks you would need for an install. But I am not going to complain, because I like that. I already have one of these that boots to DOS 5.0. Check this out! You may want to read the chapter on optimizing your system in the manual. This chapter describes how to fine-tune MS-DOS to achieve maximum performance. I may have to find a PDF of that manual for MS-DOS 5.0. Okay, so it wants disk 2. So here we are. That's disk 1. This is disk 2. Enter. Apparently that's not disk 2. Okay, is this disk 2? Why do you want... That is disk 2. Okay, well maybe it's this one then.
But these are all three of the floppies I have. This is disk one, and one of these is disk... Really? But you were going so smoothly. Oh, it's working. Okay. I'm not exactly sure why it didn't like that. Good thing I caught that on camera. Something told me to turn the camera on about this time. So that means this one should be three. Better be three, let me put it that way. I always gotta sound vaguely threatening. Operation again. I think that drive might be failing. I might need to clean the heads. Might need to take it apart and clean those heads. Good news is, I do have another floppy that I can use. Oh, joy. There's probably something wrong with this drive. So, that means I need to take the front of this computer off. I have to undo that tape. I have to take the front of this computer off, take the case off, take the floppy drive out, clean it, and then I'm going to have to leave the case apart while I'm installing it, take the floppy drive out of the ReactOS machine. Not that it was very useful, because that motherboard doesn't support a floppy drive anyway, just to have it on hand in case I can't repair that floppy drive. This is a lot more complicated than I thought it was going to be. Here we are. I took the floppy drive out of the computer, which, in order to get to that, it has a shroud that goes all the way over the computer instead of a side panel. So, and in order to get to those screws, you have to take brutally rip the face off of the machine in order to get to it. Yeah, not a fun procedure, because when you're working with 20-something-year-old plastic, you're always going to break it. This one is our drive. I want to keep it because I don't have a white bezel drive that I can stuff into this machine. That stepper motor is of nice quality. As you can see, it has wires going to it instead of a little ribbon cable. So, what you do is you take a screwdriver under there and you pry it over that lip on each corner. And at that point, on this one in particular, and there you go. You can see heads lift up and they're kind of dirty, and I'm probably going to put some oil on this stepper motor shaft here, because when this spins it moves the heads back and forth, and if that's a bit too sticky it can move it not enough, and then you get these read-write errors. It could also be possible that my USB floppy drive is in need of this exact type of service as well. But this is all you really need to do, is clean the heads, lubricate the shaft, but I'm going to probably go one step further and blow it out with the air compressor, and then I'm going to clean the heads, and then I'm going to weld the stepper motor shaft, and I'm going to slap this top cover back on. I'm going to slam it back in the machine and see what it does. If I'm still getting those issues, I'm going to do the exact same procedure to my USB floppy drive, and hopefully all of this works. And unlike hard drives, you can very well take this top cover off, plug it up to a computer, stick it in it, and watch as it reads the disc in real time, which I think is pretty neat. I might make a video on that one day, because I did it with one of my USB drives. Anyway, hope this was useful to someone. So, I'm going to go ahead and get busy. Okay, so I thought about not filming this, but I figured I would anyway, just to show you all if this drive does happen to come back to life. You can see, still the same white bezel drive. And I'm going to take a little bit of alcohol on a Q-tip, and I'm going to rub it on one of the heads. Don't really want to have it soaking, but you don't want to have it too loose either. And you just lift it up, and you start wiping the head with it. And a little bit of dirt. And now for the top one. I didn't even add any alcohol to that. Okay. Now we just clean it off. Back to the bottom one as well. Now I'm going to dry them off with another Q-tip. I'm just going to roll it over the head. And now I'm going to use WD-40 Specialist White Lithium Grease. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. See the little bit I put on there? That's a little bit too much. But I'm sure it won't be. There we go. And I'm hoping the smart thing would be to wipe that off with alcohol. So before you apply the new grease. So that's kind of what I'm going to do now. There. And now we wait for that to dry. Before I apply some more. So I'm just going to hurry up and speed up the progress a little bit. Now we apply it. There we go. And now, because I think some of that may have splattered on the heads, I'm going to come back by with another Q-tip. Just wipe them just in case. And now, I can see where some of that stuff splattered on up in there, so I'm going to take a Q-tip and just wipe it off. And now, I'm going to take the top cover . Slap it back on the drive. We slap the drive back in the drive caddy, and we slap the drive caddy back in the computer, and then we start it up, see if it works. If it don't work, then I have to take one out of the ReactOS machine. So here's to the moment of truth to see what it does. Oh, gotta put my keyboard back down. And I can't push the button because the front cover isn't on. There we go. Seems to be running faster now, doesn't it? But I think that's why it wasn't seeing disk 2, because it wasn't booting properly. So now we need to exit out of the DOS shell. Take our boot disk out, set up one, set up. There we go. It's not going to format the drive. I don't like that. I don't like that. I want it to. So I'm going to go ahead and. Well, no, I'm not going to go ahead. I was going to change it back to C, CD drive, and then floppy, but no, I don't want to do that. Skip memory test. I'm going to upgrade this while I have it open to 256. But I want to format the drive first. Funny, have it set to boot to DOS shell, but I don't need to. Oh joy, it's still having errors. Delete. Okay, so now we run setup, it should format the drive again, and hopefully, when I insert disk 2, it works. Hey, it does. Wonderful. There we go. So here we are. It's almost finished. Okay, remove floppy drives. Except I need to delete to enter setup. Now we change this. Hey! It runs. This is the first OS that's had installed on it. And there's no mouse driver. Okay. We will fix that. This is the first time I've seen it run. Alt. Okay. Display options. No. Alt. View. All files. Yes, there we go. Wonderful! Look at all of the stuff we have to play with. Let's try our old friend. Why is that one called Money? I don't know. Where is Edit? Let's see here. Let's go ahead and Alt. You can't see what I'm doing up there. Options. Display. I used to play around with that. Anyway, so here we are. MS-DOS on the Colorado. Although I want to make sure Windows 3.1 can install on this version of MS-DOS. I think I have 3.11. Anyway, so I'm going to leave the computer running. It's weird seeing it as C/DOS if I do DIR. Okay, what if we do CD dot dot? Hey, DIR. There's our stuff. Okay. Cool. I'm gonna leave this running while I prepare the disks for 3.1. I got the files from Microsoft Windows 3.1 on my iBook G3. And the best way to get the files off were to burn them onto a CD. Like, literally. I have a few things here we can try on Windows 3.1, I think. But, yeah, we're burning from a CD to a floppy disk. Yeah. Okay, so now we see how fast the Colorado boots up. Then we stick this disk in the drive and see if it tells us the good or bad news. Skip that. Give us the fastest chance possible. Okay. There is our disk. I think there's something wrong with this disk. Okay, so here's another disk. Something tells me that's not right. Okay, well, let me get another floppy drive here. This one might be in need of cleaning. I got another floppy drive here. A TIAC. See if it's any better. Wondering if I don't need to restart this computer over here. Sam asking it to do some pretty stupid stuff. I might need to start busting into these.
I hope Windows 2000 doesn't put up as much of a pain as this has. Hey! It's working! Finally! Oh, I like the fact it beeps at you.
Okay, so that was disc one, and it fell on the floor.
And everyone ready. That better be disc two, otherwise that disc is bad. And it's working wonderful. I'm going to get working on disc three. Hopefully this gives us some sort of mouse drivers for DOS shell as well. So I'd like to be able to run them both interchangeably. Dang, that was fast. I'm not even done burning disk 3 yet. Sheesh. Okay, you get the drill. This is going to happen 4 more times. Okay, so apparently I didn't need the 4th image. So here we go. And it didn't work. Okay, DIR. What went wrong? Set up. Question mark. Okay, so drop delete. So I messed up somewhere. That must be setup one. I don't know what went wrong. I'm gonna figure this out off camera. Here we are. Oh, this is so exciting. Okay. Oops. I imagine it's going to ask for other thing. So yeah, you can't run this through DOS shell. You have to run it through the regular DOS thing. But I've never seen this setup screen before on actual hardware. I never thought that this would be happening. Ever. My own 90s PC? I don't believe it. Of course you want disc 4. I shall give. Press enter or choose continue. Should we run the tutorial? Okay. That's two lessons. If you want to learn how to use the mouse, you need to brush up on your mouse skills. Press M to begin the mouse lesson. Let's go ahead and do mouse. Okay, press the enter key to continue. And R. That's neat. Huh.
Oh, this is cool. I know, kind of boring for you all, but I have never seen this before. I didn't even know this was a thing. Okay, I'm done with this now. I know how to use it. Okay. So here we are. Windows 3.1 on the Colorado. I almost dumped my floppies everywhere. Okay, so I think next we need to do is upgrade this machine to 256 megabytes of RAM. How many slots do I have? I have 4 freaking slots. So I might upgrade it to 300 and something. I'm not sure. Because I can do that. Okay. So it's still going to boot to DOS shell. Which is not really desirable. And there we are. That was quick. Okay. No. So, there used to be a fan here, but it was having kind of a hard time starting up. And I don't feel comfortable leaving it in there, but I also don't feel comfortable just leaving the space open with no airflow. So, I'm going to use one of my tiny fans and a zip tie. And I'm just going to zip tie it right in there. So it will at least have some sort of airflow. Okay, so I installed the fan in front. Let's look for PC133 memory. And I can tell right away this is not PC133 because it doesn't have two of these little slots. So that's off to the side, not PC133. Yeah, this will work. Not so many freaking DDRs. What is this? DDR2? Yep, PC2. You can also tell because the whiteness of the pins, they're wider. They're probably DDR. If they're narrower, then they're probably later than DDR. Here we go. Here's a PC2. And don't tell me what size it is. So probably 128. Oh, another one. Okay. So this says 256. I'm looking for 128. It's 512. Wait, 512? DDR? Huh. Okay. I'll have to keep that in mind. More DDR. More DDR. So much DDR. Okay. I could easily put this machine up over a gig. So this is a 64 megabyte PC133. We will use it. And there is no more. So this is our selection we have to choose from. We have a 128 and 64. That will put us at around 300 megabytes. Which should make Windows 3.1 happy. But I do wonder if we could stick these in there and it'd be perfectly happy. Do you really want to find out? I think we should. So that should be 700 megabytes of RAM, roughly. Let's see if it even boots, or if it just complains. It actually does. Holy crap. What does the MIM test say? This is going to take forever. I will be surprised if Windows 3.1 boots with no issues and no complaints. I don't think it will. little fan's blowing a little bit of air.
It keeps climbing.
Look at that. Holy crap. Oh, that will be amazing if Windows boots with no problems. 600. Almost 700. 700. It's going to stop sometime. Maybe. 800? Nope. Close. 786 megabytes of RAM. Wow. Wow. I am impressed. Let's see if Windows 3.1 or even MS-DOS will boot with this much RAM. Oh, man. Wow. Wow. I never would have thought. I just realized I might have another computer. I need to put that stuff in there. In here. I'm just looking for Win, so I can start Windows and see if it even works. Hey, it did! Let's go to about Windows 3.1. So it doesn't use all of my RAM. That's cool. Okay. So I'm going to put it at around 300 megabytes of RAM, because I think that's what this system would come with, because it only has a 300 megahertz Pentium 2, and I have a 350 megahertz PowerMac G4, and it only has 300 megabytes of RAM. So 300 seems like a lucky number you would probably have back in the day on a system like this. So yeah, I found an extra 128 stick laying around. So there's three 128 sticks and one 64. So that's about 400 megabytes of RAM. So let's see if they're all okay. 393 megabytes of RAM, and all of that was out of focus. 393 megabytes of RAM. That should be plenty. Well, I say plenty. That should be good enough for running Windows 2000. Yeah, gotta learn to use more pessimistic wording. Good enough. Just gotta be better than the last guy. In this case, last guy is my Power Mac G3. No, G4. Well, both of them. I think there was a thing where you could get Windows 3.1 to see more than 128 megabytes of RAM. As crazy cool as it would be. Can I just... there's no mouse drivers. Okay, here's an idea. View. Dual file lists. Well, this isn't that much better. Oh, wait, there it is. Okay. So, let's get out of DOS shell and, Okay. Okay, Control-Alt-Delete. We will skip the MIM test this time. Except it didn't give me a MIM test. Okay. Okay, there we go. We now have Windows 3.1. Now all that's left to do is install Windows 2000, and then I am done with this video for now. Part 3, I'm pretty sure, because this video has gone on for long enough, will be playing around with Windows 3.1 and Windows 2000, making them what I want. Moment of truth. Will we install Windows 2000? Bitch, you better give me that back. Thank you. On the HT Colorado. Control-Alt-Delete. And hopefully it boots from the CD drive. Now I can install Windows XP, but what's the fun in that? XP is boring. You never see anyone with Windows 2000. And honestly, I kind of just prefer 2000 a little bit more. There we go. Press any key to boot from CD. So excited. I'm going to go ahead and shut this other machine down for now, because I think this is all I'm going to do for the day. At least shut it down for now. Okay, to install Windows 2000 now. F8, I agree. Directory. Do not, if you still need to use an older version of Microsoft Windows, to select a different folder. And here we go. I think that Windows 95 installation is trying to haunt me. So Windows 2000 was unsuccessful in formatting my hard drive. I blame Windows 2000. So what I'm going to do is boot up from Windows Vista on this Pentium 2, try to at least, and see if I can get into the setup on Windows Vista. I'm not going to install Windows Vista. I'm just going to use it as the guinea pig that's dumb enough to format the hard drive. I just realized something. There's nothing here to tell me if I'm plugging this in the right way. Oh well. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to turn it on. Open up the optical drive. Except the optical drive doesn't open. Very easy. And now, It will tell us, hey, stupid, boot from an actual proper OS. Or it will boot just fine. But Windows ME, Windows 2000, Windows 98, and even DOS love to give me errors about my hard drive. Don't know why, they just do. Hooray! Don't you just love it? Okay, so where does that leave us? There's not a lot we can do going this point forward except rip the drive out of this system, shove it in another system, and format it as NTFS. Because I don't have a Linux that I can just plug into this machine and go. Maybe I should invest into Hiren's boot CD, but would that even help us on something this old? I don't even know anymore. Give me my disk back. Thank you. I do have Windows XP Service Pack 2, but for some reason, I don't really think it's going to help us that much. Reset button to the rescue. For when Control-Alt-Delete doesn't work. Petition to rename Control-Alt-Delete to Control-Alt-Del. Skip the memory test. I'm sick of it. Not really, but still. It's annoying. I need to know if this is going to work. What a pain this is to not only install 3.1, but Windows 2000. Will it all even be worth it? So I chose the quick format option. And what I'm going to try to do is, just before it starts installing, because I'm going to press the reset button. Okay, so it's examining the disks. That's fine. I don't care. Just do not install yet. It's creating a list of files to be copied, though I don't want them. Okay. Oops! So now, when we start up Windows 2000, it should give us the option to install it right away without having to go through the whole disk formatting crap. I have no idea if that is going to work, but I just selected quick format NTFS, and before it started copying all of its files, I just pressed the reset button. So hopefully the drive is not damaged, the partition is not damaged. It is just there, and Windows 2000 can install onto it with no issues. Okay, to set up Windows 2000 now. It's going to see the other one first. I want to put it in a different directory, and look at that, formatted as NTFS. And it didn't use that much. Leave the current file system intact. No changes. This is what we want to see, because it's not going to like formatting that again. And since we did a quick format, it doesn't really matter. So I think that's my trick from now on. Put a Windows XP drive CD in the drive. Launch the installer. Let it format the disk. And then shut it off before it has the chance to really install. And then install Windows 2000, Windows ME, whatever. Because that's what I was having to fit with all the time, was it would never install. And now I don't really have to care. So, I'm going to leave this to do whatever it wants. Wait a minute, did it give us a menu? Oh, I need to go back and look at that. I want to see if it added Windows 3.1. I'm quite impressed, really. Wow. I guess it still wants the disc. That's weird. I've never had that before. Wow. This is cool. I like this. Okay, so apparently we're all done. That was quick. CD drive was ready to get that out of there. So it's time we set this to the side. We'll click finish, let it restart. And now we see our handiwork. Where do we go from here? And here we are. We have the MS-DOS or Windows 2000 Professional. Windows 2000 Professional is what we will choose. I find it weird that it has two starting window screens. I find that really cool. I expect it to be really slow. Obviously, because we're running it on a Pentium 2. But that's the fun of all this. I wonder how high of a resolution this thing can go. I wonder what all drivers it has installed. Did it just get locked up? Hard drive light is on. I don't hear it clicking. And the mouse doesn't move. Try control delete. Nope. Okay, so now we're having issues. I'm gonna press reset. And it just locks up. Oh, joy. I encountered something similar to this on Windows 98 on an old laptop where it would freeze up at some point in the install. And I'm going to try to trick it and get around that. Because I left it running and it stayed there for way too long. Okay. So let's go ahead. Keyboard works. Oh, joy. I don't know if there's a way to bypass this. If I cancel it, if I control it, delete quickly, Oh, but it locks up anyway. Oh, man. We were this close. Okay, so what I think I need to do now is get Windows 2000 Professional No Service Pack. So, let's try safe mode. Maybe that will get us past into the desktop. Okay, and F8. And you can see, Service Pack 4. Well, the mouse still works. Yep, I think Windows 2000 on this computer is broken for now. So, I'm going to conclude the video here. We got 3.1 going. I just need to figure out a solution for 2000. And then once I do, well, then we'll start working from there on getting drivers working, customizing the installs, installing programs on there, and just overall making the Caller Auto on this channel. What does that mean? Well, it's going to be a member now, like the Scrapmaster, or the PowerMac G3, or the ReactOS machine. Like one of those. Or even the Fiery I installed Linux Mint on. You know? So, until then, I need to recover from this whole thing.